I have been into every part of the 7th Congressional District. I've been all around the city. I've been to Baltimore County. I've been to Howard County. I've talked to the people. I've heard the issues. I've heard the concerns. I've seen with my own eyes the level of need that there is all around the city and certainly the region.
That is Maya Rockeymoore Cummings, whose announcement yesterday caused some controversy because of what she said about Larry Hogan. We'll put that to the side for a second and talk about the other controversies she has regarding her nonprofit. Peter Flaherty joins me now, Chairman, CEO of the National Legal and Policy Center. Great to have you on. I appreciate you coming on the show again, because we had you several months ago who first raised these questions about the nonprofit that she has and her consulting business and the large sums of money that she received over the years from major corporations who had business in front of the committee that that Elijah Cummings used to chair. And I know you were at the unveiling of her campaign yesterday, and you questioned her about that. What did you hear? What did she say? And where do you think we are today on all of that?
Well, I did go to her home in Baltimore for the announcement event, and I wanted to confront her directly on her failure to provide us with her nonprofit's annual tax return. It's a form known as a 990. So I had the opportunity to ask her directly, and I did. And she falsely claimed to me that she'd provided the form to everyone who's asked. Now, she's not provided it to me, and I believe I was the first person to ask. At that point, she brushed by me and didn't want to speak to me anymore. But I was also happy to see that reporters there did ask her about our IRS complaint. The failure to provide the 990 is probably the least serious allegation that we make. Mrs. Cummings said that she's willing to stand before anyone and refute these claims, but so far all she's done is call us names, and she's not specifically addressed any of the charges we make in our complaint to the Internal Revenue Service.
She does not legally have to give you the 990, but has she given that 990 form to those who should be able to see it in a legal sense?
Well, she does have to give it to me. Any nonprofit executive knows that when any member of the public asks for the 990, it must be produced.
Okay.
You can't direct somebody to a website or anything like that. It's part of the Internal Revenue Code. The background on this is that I called her in April and asked for the 990. I actually asked for the address of her nonprofit because I had gone to the address on her website 3 days before and found that it was empty. There was nobody there. I asked her twice for the address so that I could come by and get the 990. And following the second request, she hung up on me. So that's part of the reason I wanted to go tomorrow and directly ask her for the 990.
Does it actually exist somewhere? Does she have that? I mean, has she shown it to anybody?
I don't know. The latest one that's publicly available is 2016. What I'm after is the 2017. And on November 15th, if they exhaust all the extensions, the 2018 will be due. Since there's been no public posting of the 2017, I do wonder if it exists, and she can clear that up by releasing it if she has it.
We're talking with Peter Flaherty, Chairman, CEO of the National Legal and Policy Center, about Maya Rockeymoore Cummings and the questions about her nonprofit and her consulting business. So why don't you walk us through? I mean, what concerns you the most? I mean, what do you think may be going on here? What do you want to find out?
Well, she had a nonprofit and a for-profit company under the same roof. She headed them both. They had extensive financial dealings with each other. That is called self-dealing. She received a full-time salary from the nonprofit, and then her for-profit collected a 5% fee on the nonprofit's expenses. That's called double-dipping. On the nonprofit's tax return, she checked the box for no when asked if the nonprofit was a party to any transaction with a business owned by a director or a trustee. She answered that falsely. Tax returns are filed under penalty of perjury. Most significantly, the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation dumped more than $10 million into this entity, over the years. Some years the money went to the nonprofit, some years the money went to the for-profit. There didn't seem to be any distinguishing feature between the two entities. And the IRS code requires arm's length transactions, and it requires a bright line between nonprofit and for-profit activities.
That is a charity of the arm of the Johnson & Johnson Company, which did have business in front of the committee that was chaired by Elijah Cummings.
That's correct. It's a huge foundation. Johnson & Johnson executives serve on the board of the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation.
So are you alleging, or do you think, that they were basically funneling money to Maya Rockeymoore Cummings in order to get favor with Elijah Cummings and obviously his powerful position of being the chairman?
Well, I think so. Why would they dump $10 million into Mrs. Cummings' foundation? The year before they started making their large grants, the foundation had revenues of $1,000. So it was almost like it was a creation of special interests like the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation. Our question is, and we don't focus this in our complaints, but it was prompted by our research, what happened to the money? There's some evidence of some activities. They held some conferences. They put out some publications. But by and large, I don't see $10 million worth of activities.
Do you have to prove that there was a quid pro quo there, though, to use a phrase that's kind of popular in another part of Washington right now?
No, we don't. I think, in a way, it's a political question, and it's something the public can decide. But our IRS complaint cites very specific violations of the Internal Revenue Code, and that's what we want the IRS to investigate, and it's what we want Mrs. Cummings to address.
Where do you think the IRS investigation is? Is the IRS taking this seriously, in your view?
Well, they've acknowledged receiving our complaint and our amendment. They don't talk about investigations when they're underway. Of course, in recent years, the IRS has been politicized and biased, and I hope that will not be the case here, and we will get a fair, independent, and prompt investigation of our charges.
Is there a timetable on that, or they can just do it whenever they want to do it?
No timetable. IRS moves very mysteriously. But when they move, they do move. So let's see what happens.
All right. Peter, pleasure to have you on. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks, Bryan.
Peter Flaherty, Chairman CEO of the National Legal and Policy Center, and was at the rollout of the Maya Rockeymoore Cummings campaign event yesterday with the latest on his complaints about the IRS 990 forms not being made available, at least to him. 816 on WBAL.